At first blush, these door panels look magnificent. They're black, and they fit, and there's no cracks in the armrest.
This week on Auto RestoMod, Jeff goes it alone to show tips and tricks for sweet Camaro Deluxe door panel fitment.
National Parts Depot is proud to offer this exclusive reproduction of the 1970-78 Camaro dash pad. Get one for your car and improve your ride. Check out National Parts Depot for Mustang and Cougar, Camaro and Firebird, Chevelle and GTO, Ford truck and Bronco, Chevy truck, Mopar, and Thunderbird. At our four locations, we stock the largest selection of classic car parts anywhere. Visit us at nationalpartsdepot.com or call us at 888-893-FAST.
Right, this week we're jumping off into some GM stuff. We've been doing quite a bit of Ford stuff. Not that most of what we talked about had a lot to do with Ford, mostly general information, but still, it was kind of Ford-centric. But this week we're gonna be working on something completely different, and that is our 68 Camaro that we've had in here before. Now, at first blush, these door panels look magnificent. They're black, and they fit, and there's no cracks in the armrest, and there's problems. Of course there's problems, that's the way it always goes. Now, one of the first things I notice on these door panels when I start looking at them is they may have indeed been a different color, because right here on our Beltline weather strip, if you watch my fingernail here, I can pull paint off of the edge of the Beltline weather strip chrome molding, and that tells me right now that even if they were black, they've probably been repainted at some point. The other problem with these door panels that's immediately apparent to me on the top of them is these are 69 door panels, because the lock knob on 69 moved from back here where it was in 68 up to here where it is for 69, and since they didn't want to go in and change the lock knobs and all that kind of stuff, they just went in and put a button in there. Sometimes people astound. Anyway, there's other small problems going on with these door panels. I would imagine the backside of these are pretty badly eat up around the holes for the clipping mechanism. Now, for instance, right here you can see a screw that's holding the door panel on the door. That's not factory, and that's a potential noisemaker and a paint scratcher if it's not in the right spot. And you also have some warbling along the bottom of the panel down here. This panel is actually kind of flowing out a little bit. Now, that's typically a water issue. I would be willing to bet there may be water shields on here now, but at some point in this door panel's life, there probably weren't water shields on here. So I'm going to pull these off here in just a second and go through all of that, but I just kind of wanted to show you what it is that you can have going on. This car is so nice, I would hate to have this, because a Camaro guy walking up on this car is going to know exactly what we've got here. He's going to know that this has a 69 door panel and somebody's moved the lock position back. That, for me, kind of wrecks this door panel on such a nice 68 Camaro. So today, we're fixing these bad boys. But first, I want to talk about what we're going to be using to potentially fix these and stuff that's available, and we're going to go over a little bit of good, better, best. Oh my gosh, that hurts. All right, now what I've got here on the table is pretty much all the needful things you're going to want to do a deluxe door panel install. One of the problems on this car is the actual door latch, the spring is broken on it. I'm just going to replace the entire latch and get it out of there. We're going to put new handles in. These are the discussion plates for the actual pull handle at the top of the door. They go with this piece here. Screw kit for that. This is the screw kit for installing the actual door panel itself. We have brand new Camaro logos that we're going to be putting on the door panels, because the ones that are on there are just kind of a little suspect, not as nice as they could be. We also have brand new lock knob grommets. The ones that are on the car are pretty beat out. These are nice and brand new and look pretty. All right, now what I'm going to talk about right here is good and best. Now, there's nothing wrong with this lock knob. Quite frankly, it looks just fine. It would work great in most driver applications. I don't mind it at all. No problems with it. A better solution, though, is this one. It's a little more expensive, but this is actually a cast lock knob that the guys at National Parts Depot sell as well. If you're going for a driver that you're not really that concerned about, this is probably a great solution. If you're going for a concourse type restoration where you're going dead nuts on everything, this one right here is the way to go. Now, the last part of this is going to be our door panel. This door panel comes from National Parts Depot as well. All right, it already has on the back side of it here the top weather strip installed, stapled in like it was from the factory. The line is nice and straight. The one that's on the car was not. The back of the panel is nice because it's ABS plastic. This originally was a fiberboard piece, and it didn't hold up that well. It would actually kind of come apart on you pretty badly. The only thing we may have an issue with on this is with the ABS, we're going to have to find our spot on the door to put our panel for our power windows on this car. But I prefer it to have the ABS. So we probably wouldn't technically need these Mylar water shields to go inside the car, but we're going to install them. Got them from National Parts Depot. They'll keep the inside of this door really nice and dry. So the next thing up is for us to go back to the car now and start taking things off so we can put things on. Oy. Okay, now first order of business, I'm going to take this discussion plate here out. This is what I was talking about. That's not normal. It should return. In any case, I'm going to remove it and get the pull handle out of the way. This one's pretty tatty looking, so I'm going to replace it. All right, I'm going to get this other one out of here. The other one dropped down inside the door panel. I think we can recover it. Okay, now you can see on the face on this thing, it's pretty nasty. It's all scarred up. I really want to replace this one, so it's going to go away. I'm going to save the fasteners because I never throw away fasteners if I don't have to. Bye. I'm going to take the plate. Take the plate off. I just hit a camera guy. We got more. This one comes off pretty easily. Just two Phillips head screws. One on either side. Oops, there's a hidden one way back there in the back. I think this is an original discussion plate. I may try to retain this one. And then there's one back over here that holds it in place that way. You see the original numbers here on the door panel. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and remove the screws from around the perimeter of the door. There should be screws along the bottom. There shouldn't be two screws across the top here, which are holding the door panel in. Shouldn't be that way at all. All right, the next thing I'm going to pull off is my door handle here, your pull handle for getting inside the car. And there's two Phillips head screws just right up underneath on the handle on either side of it.
Dos.
Okay, that's off. This is actually not in too bad a shape. We could probably reuse these if we wanted to. So, all right, so we've got a screw here, one here, one over here, and our final one is this one right here, and those will need to come out also. I'm not going to show you how all these come out because it's taking screws out. All right, got the rest of them out, and I'm going to take this one out. This one is not supposed to be here. This is an add-on thing, and like I've said before, that can cause you some problems with messed up paint. Now, I'm going to pull the door panel off. Door panel's nice and loose. I don't see any kind of pull coming from there. I can pull it off. And the connector here, the GM uses a pin-style connector. This just pulls off. And that comes off from the door. Now we're going to need our door here to actually go in and use this one to find out where our power window hole needs to be on our new door panel, because we're going to have to cut that. He says he's having problems with connectivity on his back switches. I don't really see anything here unless it's the fact that these pins are kind of pulled out. You can look at the back of the plate and see how it's bent. That may be what's causing his issue. Not real sure that's my problem today. No, it's not. Right, so I'm going to take this over to the table and start setting everything up for reapplication. But I will show you something here on my knees. See how this is all bent up? This is all a nice thick plyboard back on it. But you can see how the bottom edge has gotten wet and damp. And it's rolled out on it. So that's where part of the problem with this thing comes from, with this looking pretty bad along the bottom edge. We've also got all of our trim on here still, so we're going to look at maybe reusing this. I'm going to show you some things on how to clean that up at the table now. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to check out my stainless on this existing door panel to see if I can reuse any of this stuff. I use a product called Autosol, and As you can tell, my Autosol is pretty well used up here, but this stuff works great for this kind of problem, if you will. And I'm basically just going to run it all up and down here and see what it does to shine up my stainless, which I think I'm probably just going to reuse this stuff because it looks like it's shining out pretty good. You can see what it's done on here where it's pulled. I can smell the metal working. Yeah, that's looking nice. I'm going to reuse this for sure. Now, honestly, we kind of over-ordered. We ordered in our parts because I didn't know what we were going to get with these door panels. So most of this stuff's going to go back to National Parts Depot that we don't use. But you can look at that and see how much nicer that is. And I want these all polished up before I put them on the car. Also, if you're changing out the door panels and these are already on the car, leave them on here to do most of your polishing because they're clipped on the back side. So I'm going to go ahead and finish up this other one and get it cleaned up as well. And then we're going to turn these over and start taking them apart. All right, I clean those up. I'm going to roll the door panel over and take them off. Now, basically on a Camaro, there's just these clips. Ford used this as well. We're also going to remove, declip our power window switch. And we'll need to be taking some measurements off of this to transfer over to our existing door panel. You'll just want to grab a flat blade screwdriver to roll these out. I like to try to keep at least three of them in play if I can. All right, let's get the rest of these clips off. Bend them up carefully. If you aren't careful with them, you can snap these off. There's enough of them on these door panels that you can typically do all right with it. Just be gentle. It's old. All right, I'm gonna give you a hot tip, but this one is very dangerous to do, and that is to use a heat iron to open up holes in your door panel for your trim pieces. Now, what I've got here is basically a point hot iron that you use for doing woodworking, things like that. And I've set this one up. Basically, all I do with this is carpet and this kind of work here, because if you use this, you don't want to try using this to do any kind of soldering work. It'll just take you days to get the tip clean enough. So it's basically just all this is for is working interior stuff. And whatever you do, don't touch the hot stuff. Bad juju. Now the problem is that you could actually nail down your door panel up here and sit around and cry a lot after it's over, but in doing this you also won't damage your carpet like you can if you're doing this with a drill motor. So you take two risks. You can risk either damaging the door panel or you can risk unthreading your carpet, and personally I'm more into not threading the carpet. And it is still, regardless, quite unnerving. I'm going to go ahead and finish this one up, and I'll show you what this looks like after we get these done. All right, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to kind of lay this up so you can see what I've done. On our door panel, there's a certain spot that this trim piece needs to sit where the pins go through, and what I'm going to do is I would recommend taking and marking the positions with some kind of white pencil or something, and I would leave this in place and just mark the spots as they go around on the whole trim piece here. I'm going to take this aside now and do the same thing. I'm going to go in and burn my holes in the trim panel with this, like butter. And then I'm going to flip the panel over and do the backside. So now we have our positions, we know where they're at, and we can open these up and make them a little clearer and easier to get the pins down inside the hole. I'm going to probably go in, because my pins are a little bit small on this, I may go back in and drill these out a little bit too. So I'm going to go in and get my drill motor and on the front, from the front side, drill these holes out. And the next step will be to go in and set up our grab handle on top up here. All right, I've got these drilled out and opened up a little bit. Like butter. Do the same thing on the back side and push them in to position. I always try to put pressure down on them as I'm pushing them in so that they sit nice and deep in the panel. Use a flat blade screwdriver to push them over sometimes too. Okay, that part of it's ready to go. Looks really nice. All right, now I'm going to put the pull handle on here. Now you've got these pieces are held on with a single Phillips head screw to the actual pull. I'm going to set it in position and let it get comfortable. I'm going to hold it where it's at and mark it with like a Phillips head screwdriver. I'm going to make the hole in here pretty big compared to the other because this actually screws into the door. I'm going to pull that out of the way. And I'm going to use my iron again to go in and make my holes. She'd have a mask on. We'll let that cool for a sec. Get out from underneath the smell of that. I'm gonna go in and clean this up with a utility knife carefully. I wanna get as much of the stuff out of here as I can because this will affect the lay of the actual parts. Flip the door panel over. If you wanna let this stuff cool, you can let it cool a little bit and it'll be easier to cut off the excess. All finished up there. All right, now, what I've got is I've put a piece of tape down here to make sure that my line is straight. If you look at the tabs on the back of the Camaro logo here, these two are in line and this one is a little high. And so what I've done is I've put a mark on this using an auto punch. I went in and auto punched here. And now I'm gonna auto punch right on that line because I set this up so that this is here lining up with this. So I'm gonna put this right on top of the edge of the tape and auto punch right here. And I'm not gonna do anything else with that other one quite yet, because I've got to figure on making sure that these two are lined up and it'll drop in on those two. And then I'm gonna mark around that last one because it doesn't line up with anything else. I got a small bit that's about the same size as our studs here. I'm gonna drill these out. I might try to go in from the front side for the last one. All right, now I'm gonna set this on here and I'm gonna mark this by pushing this in a little bit. I'm gonna make my drill point on the front side on this. I'm gonna have to be more careful now because I'm drilling through the vinyl into the plastic. Okay, those are through. All right, I'm gonna heat the vinyl up here. I've made my holes a little bit bigger on this, so I've got more room to move. I'm gonna try to heat the vinyl up enough so that the pins will push all the way through. Start smelling, you can smell the vinyl getting hot. When the vinyl gets hot, you're gonna need to go ahead and move as quickly as you can to try to get these pins to set. You don't wanna keep this heat gun in any one place too long. This vinyl's pretty stiff, so that's one reason I'm using a heat gun on it. All right, I've been at this a couple of times, tried to use the original clips. Those don't work. So basically I've got some other clips here that we had in the box that I missed that NPD sent us. We got this pretty hot now. Using a cloth, I'm gonna hold that in position. Roll the door panel over. Apply a ton of pressure to it. Use a nut driver. Set it. In all three spots. Now, there we go. Now, what we should have is this mildly depressed into there. And as that dries, I'm going to put some pressure on the top here. What I'm going to do also is I'm going to heat a little bit. Sometimes if you get it hot enough, it'll lay over. And now you've got the look that the original panel had. The Camaro's not sitting up on top of it. It's actually kind of embedded into the panel, which is what it's supposed to look like. But overall, it looks pretty good. It's still really warm too. All right, that's pretty much everything that needs to be on the panel with it on the table. All right, now I've set my door panel in. I've gone in and made a couple small modifications internally. Probably not something you're gonna run into on your car, but on this one, we'll run into an issue with fitment up here on the front of the quarter of the panel itself. But we're good across the bottom. Levels are pretty good on it. I'm pretty happy with what I've got so far. I think that we need to go in and do some other stuff. I was having a problem with fitment on these for the pull, but now My screw hole is right there and right there, so I'm good to go on that. Now all we need to do is go in and make our mark on here for the actual switch panel. If you had a car with crank windows, you would want to make your mark for that at this point. The other thing I'm looking at is there's a wire that runs on the outside of the door. I'll show you that in just a second, but when I go in and I put pressure on the two points where I'm going to be putting in my screws on the bottom of this, we have one that goes here, and then the two that go down here. When I put pressure on this, this is picking up, and I don't know if there's something on the back side of this door panel that's causing that issue, but I'm not crazy about the way that's sitting right now. I don't know that it's a problem, but it's something that I've got to look at. So I pull the door panel off, and we have a wire, set this aside gently. We have a wire right here that's pinned in, but it's also not sitting in a good spot. In other words, rolling over, and this pick right here could be causing that door panel to sit up funny. So I may go in and work on this a little bit and see if I can get that to lay down better, because I'm not real crazy about what I got for lay on it right now. So that's so far as the fit on this. Everything else looks pretty good. Switch panel needs to be cut into the door panel. I'm going to do that next, and then we'll start fitting this thing up for final. All right, now for the guys out there that have power windows on their 68 and 9 Camaro, what I'm going to show you now may or may not actually be the right position for the power window switch assembly on the backside of the door panel. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to give you the measurements that came off of this car. Pretty sure this car may have been a factory power window car. On the Camaros, as old as they are, it's really kind of hard to tell though. Now what you want to do is you want to measure from the outside edge of the door panel to the center here. This is going to be 6 1/8 inches. From the bottom of the panel to the bottom of the switch panel is 12 1/8 inches. And the panel itself is 5 5/8 inches wide. And then the opening is 1 1/4 inch tall. So basically you want to get your perimeter measurements here and then base everything else off of these two measurements as far as how far over you need to go and how far up you need to go. What I recommend cutting the ABS plastic on the back with is basically a really nice cutoff wheel like this Dremel 4000 that we've got right here. I use this with the Dremel fiberglass cutoff wheels. It makes really short work of that ABS. And then finally, if I need to do anything else to it, I will grab an X-Acto knife and do any kind of minor cutting of the outside vinyl if I need to. So basically that's all I'm going to do for this week, because we have found that there are some problems on the door in relation to the mounting positions for the panels here and here. We have an issue that's not letting the panel mount quite correctly, and I think it's because of the window scrubs on the inside of the windows. When I shut the door, I also realized that the door itself is actually not shutting right. Glass is actually colliding at the top of the door, and the door is shutting this way. And the door should pretty much shut flat. So we're gonna go in this next week, and we're gonna basically do an episode on how to set up the glass and all in a 67 to 69 Camaro and Firebird, so that you guys can go out and get the glass adjusted just the way it needs to be for it to shut correctly. So that's our show for this week. Be sure to come back and watch us next time on Auto Resto Mod. Have a great week, folks.
It's so hot.